Assalamu alaikum, dear student. Heartiest welcome to Physics Multimedia class of Milestone College. I am M.D. Sadhuraman from Digital Compass Live Studio. Today I am here to solve some creative problems from the chapter Motion. Dear student, before that I like to mention about the present critical situation of the COVID-19 coronavirus. Dear student, I hope that all of you are well and safe in this situation. Dear student, I am highly optimistic that all of you are obeying the rules and regulations of health in this situation. Dear student, now I will solve two board creative question. So guys, let's go ahead.
Okay guys, now I am solving first creative question. It's from Select Board 16. I am reading the question from here. We will collect the question from the screen. Okay. Creative question number one. Mukul throws a cricket ball vertically upward with a initial velocity of 20 meter per second. At the same time, Nishan starts running with a uniform velocity of 6 meter per second to catch the ball from a distance of 30 meters. Knowledge-based question. A. What is called scripis? B. Number. Comprehension-based question. Power is a derived quantity. Explain it. C. Number. What was the maximum height of the ball? D. Number. Is it possible for Nishan to catch the ball before touch the ground? Explain mathematically. Okay, dear, I am solving this question. Attention, please. First question, knowledge-based question. What is scripis? The displacement of circular scale of screw gauge along with the linear scale within the time of full cycle of the circular scale is called scripis. And we know that scripis equals to 1 millimeter. Answer of B, comprehension base. Answer of comprehension base. Here, question is, power is a derived quantity. Explain it. Guys, we know that the quantities which depend on another fundamental quantities or derived quantities is called derived quantity. And we also know that power P equals to work done by T. That means P equals to W by T. Here P depends on work done W and time T. And work done W is a derived quantity and time T is a scalar, fundamental quantities. Since power P depends on another quantities, so P power is a derived quantity. Okay. Now answer of C. What was the maximum height of the ball? Or what will be the maximum height of the ball? Okay. Here, given initial velocity of the ball, U equals to 20 meter per second. Gravitational acceleration, Z equals to 9.8 meter per second square. We all know it. Here, maximum height, capital A is equals to what? We have a formula for maximum height. Capital A, we know that capital A is equals to U square by twice Z. Please put the value of the quantities equals to value of U 20 square by 2 into value of Z is 9.8. Okay, press the button of calculator. Okay, it may be 20.41 meter. Okay, this is the answer of C. Very easy question, dear. Okay, now I'll solve question number D. Okay, question of D, is it possible for Nishan to catch the ball in the air or before touch the ground? Okay, here after throwing the ball, the ball will reach the maximum height and it will come back to the ground. And Nishan will come from a distance of 30 meter. So we have to count here, measure here, the time of flying of the ball, capital T. Firstly, we have to find out, we have to measure the time of flying of the ball, capital T, and we also have to find out the required time for Nishan to come to the to reach to the spot. Okay guys, firstly we will measure the time of flight of the ball. We have here given that the initial velocity e equals to 20, z equals to 9.8. What is the time of flight capital T equals to what? We have a formula for time of flight capital T equals to 2u by z. Please put the value here, 2 into 20 for u by 9.8 for z. Press the button of calculator. Maybe it will be 4.08 or 4.1 second. Okay. Now I will find out the time required to reach the spot for Nishan. Okay, from a place distant 30 meter. Okay, fine. Okay. Now come here. The distance S equals to the distance of Nishan from the spot S equals to 30 meter. Okay. Velocity of Nishan 6 meter per second. T, small t equals to what? Small t, the time for Nishan to reach the spot. Okay, where the ball will touch the ground. Okay, fine. We have a simple formula, S equals to Vt. Because Nishan was moving with uniform velocity, S equals to Vt. Okay. Therefore, T equals to S by V. Put the value here. 30 for S by 6 for V. Calculate, it will be 5 seconds. So, after throwing the ball take 4.1 second to reach the ground, to touch the ground. But Nishan take 5 seconds to reach the spot where the ball touched the ground from a distance of 30 meter. So ball will touch the ground before the arrival of Nishan to the spot. Okay, so Nishan will not be able to catch the ball in the air. So it is impossible for Nishan to catch the ball in the air. So guys, I have solved first creative question. Okay, dear student, now I am solving second creative question. It is from Dhaka Board 16. I am reading the question from here. And attention please to the screen. The successive velocity with time of a moving car starting from rest is shown below in the data table. Here, first row is for time in second unit and second row is for velocity V in meter per second unit. Here, velocity is 0 meter per second for 0 second, 4 meter per second for 8 second, 8 meter per second for 16 second, 8 meter per second for 24 second, 8 meter per second for 32 second, 4 meter per second for 40 second, and lastly 0 meter per second for 48 second. That means the car was stopped finally. From the starting, the car was moving with uniform acceleration for first 16 second and second 60 seconds. That means from 16th second to 32 second, the car was moving with uniform velocity and the velocity was 8 meter per second. And from 32 second to 48 second, the car was moving with uniform retardation. And finally, the car was stopped. Question number A. What is called dimension? B. What is meant by the instantaneous speed? C. Number. Find out the distance traveled by the car within first 32 seconds. D. Number. Explain the nature of velocity with time, drawing a graph for the motion of that car. Okay, dear student, I am solving this problem. Attention, please. Firstly, A. Number question. What is called dimension? The power of fundamental quantities in a physical quantity is called dimension. The dimension is expressed, the dimension is denoted by the capital letter of the symbols of the fundamental quantities. Okay, number B, What is meant by the instantaneous speed? What do you mean by the instantaneous speed? The speed obtained by dividing the distance by a small interval of time of a moving car is called instantaneous speed. That means if the interval of time is small, then by traveled distance with the smaller interval of time, we get the instantaneous speed. Okay, let us consider that the distance traveled by a moving body with a small interval of time dt is ds. Now by dividing that traveled distance with that small interval of time, we will get the instantaneous speed. That means the instantaneous speed v equals to ds by dt. Okay, dear student, instantaneous speed is nothing but the real average speed of a moment around a moment. Okay, now question number C. You have to find out the traveled distance within first 32 seconds. In 32 seconds, there are two cases. From starting till 16th second, the car was moving with uniform acceleration. And next 16th second, the car was moving with uniform velocity. And the velocity of the car was 8 meter per second. So there are two cases. And you have to solve this problem in two cases. First case for uniform acceleration. Attention please, here given initial velocity u equals to 0 meter per second. Okay. 0 meter per second, u equals to 0 meter per second. Final velocity v equals to 8 meter per second. The velocity in 16 second, v equals to 8 meter per second. Time t equals to 16 second. What is the travel distance s1? We have a formula for from the motion, s equals to ut plus half t square, and another formula for displacement, s equals to u plus v divided by 2 into t. We know s1 equals to u plus v divided by 2 into t. Put the value of the quantities 0 plus 8 by 2 into 16 for t. Please press the button of calculator. It may be 64 meter. That means s1, the distance traveled within first 16 second is 64 meter. Okay. Now second case, in second case the car was moving with uniform velocity. Okay, here uniform velocity is 8 meter per second. From 16th second to 32 second, the car was moving with uniform velocity and velocity was 8 meter per second. So uniform velocity v equals to 8 meter per second, time is t, so distance s2 equals to what? We have a formula for uniform velocity. We have only one formula for uniform velocity, and it is s equals to vt. So s2 equals to vt. Put the value of v 8 into the value of t is 16. So calculate please. It may be 128 meter. Okay, s2 equals to 128 meter. So the total distance traveled by that car will be s equals to s1 plus s2 equals to 64 plus 128 equals to 192 meter. This one is the answer for C. That means the total distance traveled by that car within first 32 second is 192 meter. Okay. Now I am solving D number. Okay. D number. Explain the nature of velocity with time, drawing a graph for the motion of that car. Okay. Please draw a graph. I think that all of you are very expert in drawing graph, because you are drawing the graph maybe from 6 or 7. Okay, class 6 or 7. Okay. Here along with the x-axis we put the time in second unit, and every smaller division is for 8 second, and along with the y-axis we put time t in second unit, velocity v in meter per second unit, and every smaller division is for 2 meter per second. Okay, 2 meter per second. Okay, fine. And draw the graph. Here, first case is uniform acceleration. Second case is uniform velocity. Third case is uniform retardation. And finally, the car was stopped. Okay. Okay. First case. That means way part. I will explain way part here. For way part, u equals to 0 meter per second, v equals to 8 meter per second, t equals to 16 second, and s1 equals to 64 meter. We have find out that. Okay. Next, a equals to what? You have now only you have to find out only acceleration. Okay. I have the formula a equals to v minus u by t. Here, a equals to v minus u by t. Put the value, please. 8 minus 0 by 16. Maybe it is 0.5 meter per second square. That means at pathway, at first part, the car was moving with the uniform acceleration 0.5 meter per second square. Okay. Therefore, we can say that the car starting from rest traveled a distance of 64 meter within first 16 second and achieved a final velocity 8 meter per second moving with the uniform acceleration 0.5 meter per second square. Okay. Now, second case, that means AB part. The car was moving with uniform velocity at AB part and velocity was 8 meter per second and it was moving for 16 second with uniform velocity. So we can say the car traveled a distance of 128 meter moving with uniform velocity 8 meter per second within 16 second. Okay. Now lastly, third part, that means BC part. Okay. At BC part, initial velocity u equals to 8 meter per second. That means the uniform velocity at second part, AB part, the will be the initial velocity of third part. Okay. The uniform velocity of second part will be the initial velocity of third part, last part. Okay. Final velocity was zero because the car was stopped finally. Okay. U equals to 8 meter per second. Okay, u equals to 8 meter second, b equals to 0 meter per second, t equals to 16 second, last 16 second. Okay, now we have to find out retardation a equals to what, uniform retardation a equals to what, s3 equals to what. We have for a formula for a equals to b minus u by t. Put the value here of the quantities 0 minus 8 by 16. Maybe it will be minus 0.5 meter per second square. That means the car was moving with a retardation of 0.5 meter per second square at BC part. Okay. And S3 equals to U plus V divided by 2 into T. Okay. Put the value here 8 plus 0 by 2 into 16 for T. Okay. Calculate. It may be 64 meter. Okay. The displacement at third part is 64 meter. So, therefore, we can say that the car starting from the initial velocity 8 meter per second travel a distance of 64 meter moving with a uniform retardation of 0.5 meter per second square and after traveling 16 second it achieved a velocity of 0. That means the car was stopped finally. Okay guys, we have solved two creative questions. Now write down the SW from the screen. Okay,
so guys, that's all from my side for today. Thank you very much for staying with me and being attentive. Very soon I will come to you with a new topics and I will solve your problem. Till then, be well and safe and take care of you. Allah Hafiz.